Now we talk about motivation for check cohomology. You start with topological space X and consider a constant sheaf on it. So f of u is equal to, we are writing integers here, but you could write any set here. So f of u is any set, and you take u to be an open subset of this space X. So let us fix S to be unit circle S1. And this S1 has open cover, say consisting of two sets, U1, which is S1 minus 1, and U2, which is S1 minus this minus 1. So let us draw this. So this is, say, U1. One is missing here. And then we have, say, U2. Here, minus 1 is missing. Now both U1 and U2 are connected sets. So you have f of U1 is integers and f of U2 is also integers. So f of UI is integers. Now we write intersection as U1, 2. So intersection of these two sets will give us something like this. And we have two points missing here. So you have point missing here and point missing here. So minus 1 is missing here and 1 is missing here. So this is U1, 2. That is U1 intersection U2. Now this has two connected components. So the first component gets mapped to integers. Second component also gets mapped to integers. So you write f of U1, 2 is this. Whereas f of U2 was just integers. And same for f of U1 was also integers. Now in general, this f of u is equal to this, where I is the number of connected components. So now we have a standard diagram, which is say U1 and U2, say S1. So U1 is contained in S1, U2 is contained in S1, and then this U1, 2, this is contained in U1, this is contained in U2. So this is just simple inclusion. All of these are just nothing but simple inclusions. So I've drawn these hooks so that you can understand this is inclusion. Now, once you apply a sheaf to it, there is a contravariance. So the arrows have reversed. So all these arrows have reversed, which just shows there is contravariance. So first notice that these two maps are ISO. Why are they ISO? So say you have a circle. So this is your circle, S1. And this circle, say, gets mapped to some integer. Pick up something, say minus 7. Then this U1, this is a connected subset of S1. So some function, some continuous function is acting on S1 and mapping all the S1 to one number, minus 7. Then that same function will also map this U1 to minus 7. Because U1 is a connected subset of S1. Similarly, U2 will also get mapped to minus 7. Because U2 is a connected subset of S1. So basically, we took some function on S1, which was a continuous function, it mapped to minus 7. So this map is an ISO. So if there is some section here, S, it will get mapped to S here. So instead, if there was some function which mapped S1 to 3, then correspondingly that same function will map this to 3, it will map this to 3. So there is an ISO here. So these two are just ISO. So because, again, I'm just writing it, since UI is a connected subset of S1. Now we want to see map from f of UI to f of U1, 2. So we have seen that we want a map from integers. So this is integers and this is integers. We want a map from here to here. So how do you get this map? So say you have some section here. Say you have section A here. So this section A, so on this set it is A. So when you restrict it to these two components, it will again be A and A. Yeah, so this A gets mapped to A comma A. Or you can rewrite this as A times 1 comma 1. So you could also write it as A restricts to A minus A in case there is a Mobius band as the vector bundle on it. So you can say it could also restrict to A 1 minus 1. Other way to see it is this both 1 and minus 1 are generators of integers. So 1 and minus 1 are generators of integers, and that's how this A could get mapped to 1 or minus 1. I want to focus more on this, that you know why this minus 1 comes about, and let us draw the figures to actually understand this. So we have opened the circle up. So this circle we are expressing as 0 to 2 pi. So this is a unit circle. So a circumference we have opened up, and in the end we are going to identify these two points together and you will get a circle. Similarly, if you identify these two points together, you get a circle. Now we are putting these integers on it. So basically integers will look like this. At 0 there is integers here. So say you have 1 here, 2 here, so on, and then you have minus 1, minus 2 here, so on. So you have these lines corresponding to every point. So we have this, and similarly we put these lines on the second circle. So now in case 1, A11 means we are going to identify, say, some A here with A here. In the second case, A minus 1, 1 here, what you are doing is you're going to identify this A with minus A here when you glue the circle. And here you get a Mobius band. And here you get, you know, standard vector bundle, trivial vector bundle. So let us see this. For this purpose, I'm going to shade the negative part in rust color. So you glue these two pieces together, you get something like this. So you have this top circle, and then you have a boundary circle. So let us make the bottom part in rust color. So this is the trivial vector bundle. So this bottom part is the negative part. Let us now draw the Mobius. So for Mobius, we draw it like this. And this middle part is green, so green will go on like this. And then let me draw the positive part. So the positive part is on the top. You start on the top. And then the negative part. So we have constructed, you have either A 1 minus 1 or A times 1 1. Similarly, this B you either get to map to B 1 1 or B 1 minus 1. So you make a choice whether you want to do 1 1, you just take 1 1. Or you make another choice, you say I want to go with 1 minus 1, then you take B also as 1 minus 1. So this is how the mapping would be. Yeah, this is obvious because you know U1 contains U12. So if it is taking value A on U1, it has to take value A on U12 on both its components. Similarly, if it is B on U2, U12 is contained in U2. So it will be, it has to take value B here, and then you have to multiply B with generators. So you fix the generators, either you fix 1, 1 as generators or 1, minus 1. So that is pretty much it. So this map is like this. Anyway, this is not going to matter. I'm just writing this so that we can tie this with vector bundles some point later. So where 1 and minus 1 are generators of integers. So since we are talking about cohomology, you need a complex, because if you have a complex, only then you can compute its cohomology groups, and that is the purpose. So for a complex, this f of s1 you write here, this is integers. Then you have f of u1 times f of u2. You write f of u1 times f of u2 here. And this is f of u12, which is comes from this. So we want to make this a complex. So to make it a complex, if you start with some section here, this should get mapped to 0, 0 here. That is, this s should get mapped to 0 times the basis. So we'll pick basis as 1, 1. Doesn't matter, you could have picked up 1 minus 1. You multiply with 0, you will get 0. So how do we do this? So consider there are two sections here. So you have S1 here, and then you have S2 here. So this D0 acting on S1 and S2, D0 acting on S1, S2, if it is S1 minus S2 times 1, 1, so any two elements S1 and S2, this will get mapped to S1 minus S2, and then you multiply it by 1, 1, this map. So if both of them are coming from the circle, so if S1 and S2, so in general, this will be the case. But if this S, this section here is coming from the circle, now this S when restricted to set U1 will still be S. So we had talked about that S restricts to S here. When restricted to U2, it will still be S. So S minus S will give you 0. So this thing works. And thus you have a complex. Now since you have a complex, now you can compute the cohomology. So we want to compute cohomology. So we will compute cohomology right here at this complex. So kernel of this map, everything here is getting mapped to 0. So kernel is integer. And then you modulo out by image. So image of D0. So we are computing complex. Computing complex is right here. We are computing cohomology on this complex. So everything is getting mapped to 0. So everything is in the kernel. Modulo image. Image of D0. Image is nothing but S1 minus S2. So S1 minus S2 is an image. So this is combination of two integers. This is itself an integer. So image is an integer. And this will give you integers. Now we want to copy the same method forward. So the trick is this. So say you have section S1 here and you have section S2 here. So we want S1 minus S2. So another way to write this as, so when it this gets mapped to U12, so S1 remains as S1, but 2 is missing. So you write S12 hat. This S12 hat is again means the same thing as S1 with 2 missing. You're putting hat on 2 means 2 is missing. Similarly, S2 you can write as S1 hat 2. 1 is missing. So now you rewrite this as, you multiply this by minus 1 and you raise it to the power of what has hat on it. So here 2 has hat on it, you put 2. Here 1 has hat on it, so you put 1 and you add it. So you get S1 minus S2. Or in other words, from this complex, from F of U1 times F of U2, when you go to F of U12, you basically say you have taken section from here. S12 hat comes from U1. Multiply this by minus 1 to the power of 2 because 2 is missing, plus S1 hat 2, and then you multiply minus 1 to the power of 1. So you have S1 hat 2, so minus 1 raised to the power of 1, which is same as this S1 minus S2, but this is a good way to write it, and this is precisely the way you write it in Czech cohomology. You basically, when you go to the next part, you see where you are landing, and then you raise minus 1 to that power. So we will now rework this with the three covers. So circle will now have three covers, and we are going to rework this exam.